my channel. Since last class we've been discussing international experience Canada, and we have already discussed about the process and who can apply and how the pool works and what is your eligibility check and which are the countries that are eligible to apply for. These are the things that we already discussed, and if you are willing to apply, you're supposed to be fully vaccinated for IEC participations to come to Canada. And right now certain agriculture and food processing workers may be exempted. That's the note. And today we are going to discuss create a profile. How to create a profile to become a candidate if you want to travel and work temporary Canada as part of International Experience Canada IEC. Your first step is to become a candidate in one or more IEC pools. And how to become a candidate, this is the process where you find out if you meet the minimum eligibility criteria by answering some questions that we already seen. You can go back and check on my part A, part B, part 2, part 3 videos, and that will help you to understand better of what is IEC eligibility. And create a free online IEC profile if you are eligible. The answer you give us will be used to determine if you are eligible for the pool or one or more eligible IEC categories. International co-op internship that we have discussed in detail, and work holidays for young professionals also we have discussed. The eligibility criteria, so you should be between 18 to 31 years of age, and should be having an international passport and work experience. And first step to answer, use questionnaires to see if you meet the criteria to get into this IEC pool, and it will take you about 10 to 10 minutes. It'll ask you about your country of citizenship and country of permanent residence where you live permanently, and country of residence where you live now, and student status if this applies for you, and job offer if this applies to you. So your country of permanent resident is the country where you have a permanent resident. For example, if you are a Mexican student in Canada, your country of permanent resident is Mexico. So you're supposed to answer such a way. We have already discussed this in our previous videos. And second thing is complete your online IEC profile. That is, who don't need to create a new profile. So you don't need to create a new profile for the 2022 season. If you created your profile with the last 365 degree days and haven't already received an invitation to apply ITA or declined a previous ITA, so still you are eligible. If you get a positive results, you can complete and submit your IEC profile online. If you checked your eligibility without signing in following these steps, copy or write down the personal reference code we give you at the end of the questionnaires. It gives this the format. I already have checked this and I have made a video on this. You can go back and check on my previous videos. Create your account, enter your personal reference code and ask. So filling in the online forms, leave out any comment that separates your first and last names. And example, Julie, Lois, Mary. If your name is Julie, Lois, Mary, and use English and French letters only. And if your passport uses others special letters and characters, use the letter without the accent. And for example, use Z instead of Z, that is a German letter. Submit your profile. And important, submitting an IEC profile does not mean you have applied for the work permit. You need to have an invitation to start a work permit application. If you are invited to apply, you will use your account to submit your work permit applications, pay your fees and check the status of your applications. This is the only way to apply for IEC work permit. If you get an ITA, that is invitations letter, and if you do receive an ITA and work permit applications is approved, you will receive a port of entry letter of introductions in your account. This letter does not guarantee that you will be allowed to enter Canada or get the work permit when you arrive, the border services officers will make a final decisions on your entry. So without wasting much time, let us understand how to create a account. So you here there is a two options: find out if you're eligible, that we have already done, and sign in into your account. So you will get a kind of options. I already made a video on this, how to create a GC key account. So we can create that, and I already made a medical exams and biometrics also. You can watch that. If not, I'll give you brief informations here too. This is the medical exam informations. You can go and click on the surveillance. You will get all the hospitals list, and biometrics also is the same. So what I would do is, in this video I will give you this my previous videos link. This is the video that I already have created, so I will copy this link and paste it over here. So you can click on this and learn how to create new sign up account. That's all for the day, friends. Do like my videos and subscribe my channel for more updates. Share this video for the people who are looking for Canada immigrations or international pathway. You can always give the feedback that how is my videos are useful for you guys. If there is any changes or corrections can be accepted, and if you want a different country's pathway also, you can give a comment below, so that I'll do the research and try to give you informations about your favorite country's pathway. That's all for the day. Do like my videos and subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you and have a great day. Bye.